Hello and welcome to a new edition of the SWN podcast. Yes, it's been a while since I've done that. The last episode I recorded was the end of June, and we're back on a road trip as I am going to my first event since the birth of my son, since the birth of Jack, and I'm going to go see WrestleZone live in Inverurie. And so yeah, that's why you're getting my dusty steering wheel again, because I still haven't quite figured out how to mount my phone safely. I do have like a magnetic strip in the middle, but yeah, it just means you'd actually just get my arm or my shoulder, so you're just getting my face instead at this point. So we're gonna try and do the same thing again like we did for Aberdeen Anarchy, like we did for Aberdeen road trip. We're gonna go to the venue, go get some food, and then go enjoy a show and maybe take some clips, make some clips and see if I can get people to speak to me, see if I can just nut up and actually get people to speak to me. We can do that and yeah, have a bit of fun, hopefully. I can't wait. I missed Battle of the Nations because it was like just like 3 weeks after everything happened, so I was still not sleeping much, but I was sleeping even less then. So it just wasn't logistically possible for me to trust myself to drive to Aberdeen in Aberdeen, because it was at the station hotel. So that means I'd actually have to be in Aberdeen to do it. And no, everything about that sounded like the worst idea, like a perfect storm of bad ideas all in. So, but it's Inverurie we're going to this time. Hopeville Social Club. I don't know. I had a look on Google Maps and I saw it had parking, so that's all I really was paying attention for. And so I know that at least I've got a place to park. So I'm going to go drop off the boy and my parents and Bucky. They're going to have him for the evening, and then we're going to go straight to Inverurie. Might stop and get some food on the way, because you know I'm a fat man and that's just the way we do it. So the card is stacked. I'll probably speak about it a little bit later on, because I've got some questions to answer as well, which I haven't actually written down, so I'm going to have to try and memorise them before I hit play on the video. I've got some questions to answer, so we'll do that. And yeah, so I'll speak about it a little bit more in depth, but it's a great lineup, in fact, when we're talking about a show that, like I said in my written preview, that this could be classed as a smaller show, but the lineup in that is just incredible. And that main event in itself, the Foundation of the Future against Caleb, Damien and Conor Malloy, is just going to be amazing. The whole show is, they've got Fago against the Isle of Sterling, which is going to be a riot as always. I'm so excited for this show. Not just because it's the first time going back to the wrestling show since like this big life-changing event in my life. Great use of redundancy there. But just to go see some wrestling again, go see some fun. Because this is actually the first WrestleZone show. That's a lie, because I went to see W3L like the weekend after Jack was born, but it was in Elgin. So that means it was like a sub-3-minute drive to get there. But this is a bit longer and a bit more, I'm going to have to be a bit more awake to do it, because it's an evening show as well, and the one at W3L was an afternoon one. So yeah, there's lots of moving parts, lots of things happening, and I'm just so buzzing for that. So this episode itself is probably going to be a shorter one. It's not going to be like the big 2-hour epics that we've done in the past. It's not going to be, might not even be an hour. I think the 150th episode I did with the road trip for Aberdeen Anarchy, I think it was about 45 minutes. I think we could probably stretch to just about that. And I promise it's not all going to be me just peering over my steering wheel here, you staring at me like I'm in some sort of weird void. It just is what it is. But we'll see if we can try and get some footage of the show and do a little montage again. You'll get my post-show thoughts, just like immediate thoughts. And like I said, I'll answer some questions when I stop either in Inverurie or if I stop for food elsewhere. So yeah, this is amazing. My camera's just going all over the place because I'm putting it on my dashboard. So yeah, so for everyone that's still listening, the Rewind episodes have done really well, like listening wise, they've been incredible actually. I don't know if it's more because I've put them on like the footer of the website, so that means every page there's an episode of the SWM podcast now that you can check out. I don't know if it autoplays for some people or if you just mistakenly clicked. I don't care how, but we're just about tipping 15,000 listens now of the podcast, which is insane and amazing that people may be actually listening to me just ramble incoherently and hoping that whoever I'm speaking to understands there's a question in there at some point and they're able to answer it. Speaking of season, so it's kind of like a limited season. I don't really want to call it season 5, it's probably like season 4.5, because I don't know as and when I'll be doing episodes. But I do have a lineup of guests, like new guests as well as returning faces, just waiting kind of for me to go, right, when can I get you? This is the day, right, excellent. Give me 2 hours of your time and I'll speak to you about stuff. So I've got a lineup of people that are interested in being on, are up for being on, and some people that are up for coming back. I've also got some stuff in the pipeline with our Bring It Back Sharp Dojo series, so that's a thing that's possibly happening. I've kind of got that in motion. So there's a lot of stuff happening, I just haven't actually done any of it, you know. It's just a case of me finding a rhythm, finding a time to do it, because everyone that's listened to this that's had a child will probably sympathise that finding routine time. So like, I can't really go to a guest saying, right, I'll be free 7 o'clock, we'll run for an hour, because if Jack's feeds are out of sync, then that kind of kiboshes everything. It also means that, because I don't want to do it midweek recordings, because that means Kelly spent the whole day looking after him while I've been upstairs in my office for my actual job, and then for me to come down, see him for an hour, and then naff off back upstairs to speak to someone. So it's really just trying to find a balance now to get the podcast going and just see what I can do. So yeah, there's a lot ready to go. It's just getting the time and the just to go. That's the next thing. The other thing that's a pain in the arse at the moment is Zoom, because like the pandemic is apparently over. They've withdrawn their unlimited one-on-one chat recordings, now down to 40 minutes, which it's fine, but at least I know when I'm properly gonna get a string of recordings, I'll just like get the full Zoom and we'll just run them for a month, and then hopefully that'll be at least a couple months of shows ready to go for a season. So yeah, plenty on my plate, plenty, and you know me, I like a full plate. And yeah, so that's it, we're going to go see wrestling. That's the next thing that's happening. So yeah, like I said, we'll answer some questions coming up. Hopefully I'll get some people to speak to me. I'll actually be brave enough to get people to speak to me, and we'll do some stuff in the queue, or if I see anyone I know, I'll speak to them, see if we can get them on the show, and then we'll go watch the show and then do the post-show thoughts and feelings. And no doubt I'll write something, even though I'll say I won't, in the coming days for the website itself. So it's going to be a lot of fun, and I think that's enough of me rambling on the outside of Elgin, 12 miles out from Bucky. So I'm going to go and drop off the lad, and we're going to head our way to Inverurie. So, it's fine, I'm not in a car crash, it's just twats and cyclists. Right, see ya. Well, hello, quick stop in Keith after dropping off the wee man at his granny and granddad, so that's fine, it's all going well. So we're still on our way to Inverurie, just taking a wee refreshment break. I went for Monster Energy Ultra Mango something, Ultra Fiesta Mango, exciting. So we've got some questions to answer, So I'm going to answer them, the ones I remember anyway, and then we're off on our travels again. So from what I remember, we had Ronan King asking, how does it feel to see the gorgeous Ronan King for the first time since his big win at Aberdeen Anarchy? Really looking forward to seeing Ronan King again, because you know, as much as he is arrogant as a wrestler, as much as he's just a bit of a pain in the backside to a lot of people, he's so entertaining. He's so good that it's baffling that he's been doing it for less than a year in front of crowds. It's just insane. So I'm looking forward to seeing Ronan King against Chris Archer tonight, so that should be a lot of fun. ASMR for you. Got a bunch of questions from Callum Bruce as well, who will be at the show tonight. Championship, lay of land, something, Aberdeen Anarchy 2023. So of course I'm going to obviously hope that Aspen's undisputed WrestleZone champion, but realistically, you're probably looking at the foundation of the future still holding on to the titles come Anarchy next year. But I would like to be Aspen, being the undisputed champion, tag champions. Still have a foundation, would still be cool as a trio, a Freebird rule kind of thing. That would be quite interesting. Throwing in Dynamite sometimes to the tag team matches. Tri-Counties, it's Alan at the moment. Surely it has to be Caleb. That would be ideal, obviously, to have Caleb walking in with the title. That means you kind of got four guys that are 100% from the WrestleZone Training Academy being your champions. That would be really, really cool for an advertisement for the school. And also, they would just be really good to be champions at that point as well. So, there we go. There's that one. Another one is, will Aspen appear in Inverurie tonight? I would be surprised, because I think he's wrestling at Fair City tonight against Taylor Bryden for the junior heavyweight title. So I think he's down in Dundee. So if he does appear, then he's motored up the road. If he's in the opening match at Fair City, then you know, never say never. But I would hang a big doubt, a big button saying doubt over my head if I knew how to do that. But I don't think he will be. We might get some like video format. A little interruption or something, who knows, but I don't think he'll be Inverurie tonight. I think the other question was, is Omar Muhammad right in saying that Brian Tucker is a Wally? I mean, I haven't seen Brian since Aberdeen Anarchy, and he was a bit of a Wally then, so, you know, his evidence kind of adds up to Brian Tucker being a Wally. So, yeah, we'll say that's probably about right. There was another question, wasn't there? I can't remember what it was. I'll find out what it is and I'll answer it in the next segment when I either get to Inverurie or I get so bored in the drive that I decide to just run down the card again, just confirm what's happening on the show. There was a fourth question because I remember them being four. I'll find it. Carl, your question will be answered in the next bit. So I'm going to go enjoy my Ultra Fiesta Mango, my little deli meat feast, and my Pringles, and I'm going to head to Inverurie and still go find more food, because I'm going to need a proper feed before going to be entertained by the wrestling, I'm sure. So yeah, there'll be probably something in the middle of now, and there'll be a next segment, hopefully. And here we are, Hopeville Social Club. That wasn't so bad to find. It was a bit, kind of take a bit back roads to find it. There's an Aldi somewhere around about here, so go and find some food. I don't know where the entrance is. I assume it's just that front door there. But there's a little side door inside there, so it could be there. We'll soon find out. Oh, who else is here? So the match card this evening, we're here, Hopeville Social Club, where I'm going to go find some food. More food, because I'm a fat bastard. So we've got the pre-show match. We've got Sean Johnson against Murphy. That should be just good. Should be a really good match anyway, because it's the least you expect with these kind of things. Now with WrestleZone shows, all the matches are either good to great to amazing. That's just what happens. We've also got Chris Archer against Ronan King, I've already mentioned, which is going to be just
an excellent match. I mean, there's no bad matches on the show. That's just it. You can read my preview on the website, swnscotland.com, and I went into it ad nauseum about how good the show's going to be. So we've got that. We've also got the Tri-County Championship match. And the question that I missed from Callum was Caleb, will Caleb ever get hands on Alan? I think he's going to at least give it a go tonight. I'm absolutely sure. So we've got Captain Alan Sterling against Mickey Vago from the Mosh Pit. I'm looking forward to that. That's going to be fun. I think that's something's going to happen there tonight. I don't know how, I don't know what, I don't know why, but something's going to happen on that and that match. Something different, something noteworthy, I think. We've got the main event. Before we get to the main event, we've got Scotty Swift against Rhys Dawkins, which will be a lot of fun. That's the one I put in my preview, that's the one I'm going to be sports entertained by. That's the one that I'm like, yes, that's the one I'm going to enjoy so much. And along with that, we've also got, of course, Omar Mohamed against Brian Tucker himself. There's a rumour around that Brian Tucker smells, so I'm going to see if that can be corroborated as well. And then the main event, of course, it's the Foundation of the Future, Zach Dynamite, Ryan Riley, Bruiser Brad Evans against the super team of Caleb Valhalla, Damien and Connor Malloy. That's your big main event in Inverurie of all places. I'm fairly certain I've just seen Mickey Vago walk past there in the car park as well, so he could be walking out with some gold later as well. So amazing show lined up, amazing show that's hopefully going to be taking place. I'm going to find that out if it was in a little while, but in the meantime I'm going to see if there's somewhere I can get some hot food that's not, because I mean I had a cold sandwich, it was fine, but you know, need some hot food and also somewhere to pee. So next time I should appear on here, it'll be after the show probably, unless I've been able to nab some people to speak to, which, you know, 50-50 if that's going to happen. But we'll see how the show goes. Maybe next thing you see is a montage. Who knows? That's the mystery and joy of the SWM podcast, I suppose, when we're doing, when we're recording again. So, yeah. See you in the next bit.
Okay, it's co-host of KK Wrestle Factory. That's me. It's birthday.
Something's gonna happen.
Probably, I'm scared.
Yeah, it'll be captured, I'm sure. Someone will capture it on film. There you go, that's me checking the box off. I've actually spoken to someone on the podcast. There you go. You're the guest of the first one since my child was born.
There we go.
There you go. Kyle.
Bitch, you ain't seen anything. I pop off with the new rock. Electronic, blow the sonic roof up. I'm too honest when I take a few shots. They're too toxic, need to take the new song. And you cannot save me, cause I don't need saving. It's everything I've been chasing, all here for the taking. Don't wanna test your luck with me. I think I've had enough disease. I'm sick of all the bad thoughts, people who are half-nons.
You are not as tough as
post show, what was it, Inverurie, I'm, mine's all over the place. An excellent night. This, if we thought Aberdeen Anarchy was like this, when I was the post show, just yeah, I'm gone. Was all this emotional stuff that made you like just tear your hair out and made you feel feelings of distraught and just all that kind of stuff. This was how to describe it. This is WrestleZone's bread and butter. It's fun, hilarious, just a good time, and that's what happened. You'll get probably a bit more in-depth stuff on an Adam review, or if, even if I remember some stuff tomorrow, I might do some writing myself tomorrow. Obviously, that would have been done by the time the podcast comes out. Or K&K Wrestle Factory. There was so much that happened, so much good stuff, so much fun stuff, so much hilarious stuff, and then so much stuff that, again, progresses the story forward, like I've said in my written preview. It was just an excellent night. There was like hilarity. It seemed to be some wrestlers were also facing the venue at times, with Bruiser Brad and with Rhys Dawkins just miss the ring when they were trying to enter it. We had Dino and Scotty hitting their head off the roof. Same Chris Archer as well. They battled the venue, as well as having some really top quality fun wrestling matches at the same time. So I had an excellent time, even though I am absolutely shattered. I'm waiting for my pizza at Domino's. They don't sponsor the show, but I'm waiting for that because they do a walk-in deal, and it seems like a pretty sweet deal for me to eat some pizza on the way home to go pick up my boy. But no, it was so much fun. The montage was awful, and I apologise for that. It's mostly just pictures of them entering the ring, and then there's a couple pictures of me meeting the wrestlers, and I look like utter shit. But you know, I'm operating on very little sleep, but I wouldn't trade it for the world. So thank you to everyone that had some kind words to say, and a little bit of advice as well. I was speaking to Mr. P and Sean Johnson, of course, both dads themselves, and they were giving me some advice and that as well. So yeah, I wish I could form a coherent sentence, but I had an absolute blast, and it's always fun to come to WrestleZone. I've come to WrestleZone shows after my dog passed away, and I was just at the lowest point of that I have existed in, and now I'm in this tired point, but still a massive moment in my life that I've come to see WrestleZone again. And it's like my little comfort blanket. If I could do anything out with like family life that just brings me joy, it's going to see wrestling, and especially going to see WrestleZone. So that's why I keep going back, and that's why I enjoy it, and that's why I enjoy speaking to the people there. I'm a very awkward person in real life. I'm not shy in saying that. So I know that it seems, maybe to the wrestlers, it's not a lot of conversation, but to me, it's great conversation. It's important conversation, and it's something I'm still working on at 32 years of age, working on speaking to people in real life. But they treat me well, and they make it worth coming to every single time. So this has really been a really short episode of the SWN podcast. I might have an extra bit at the end once I get home and like, refreshed and have a shower. Maybe I'll do a bit from the studio. But it's from top to bottom an absolute class night, from Sean Johnson, Mahler, Murphy, to the main event with Mickey Vega winning the Tri-Counties Championship against Captain Alan Sterling. In between, we had Harry Potter chants for Rhys Dawkins. We had the excellent like collision between Caleb Valhalla and Bruiser Brad Evans, and we got a little bit of a Zach Dynamite and Damien stuff. We got some tension between Damien and Connor Malloy. We got Mr. P and Sean Johnson and Outfit colliding and having a bit of a skirmish, and we got obviously Caleb as well. He cost Captain Allen the Tri-Couch Championship, so now they're going to battle, and there's no title on the line. It's now just a personal revenge rivalry. There's so much going on in WrestleZone, and I'm hoping, I am praying, I will try my best to be at Halloween Hijinks mainly one to see all these stories kind of continue or conclude, but I want to see Aspen versus Zach Dynamite as well. So there's so many things that you have to go see. I mean, for me Inverurie is what, an hour maybe, if that, an hour up the road. But guys like Kyle and Kayleigh from the K&K Wrestle Factory, they've traveled up from Glasgow to a smaller show. They've actually come to Inverurie to see a show, and that is testament to WrestleZone and their ability to tell these stories, to get you invested in these stories and these characters and these moments, and it's just an absolute blast. And the other thing about Halloween hijinks, we've got Ronan King challenging Grado, and Ronan King is really fast becoming one of just a really complete package wrestler. He's so easy to dislike, which makes you respect how good of a job he's doing. And to see him, if he's against Grado at Halloween Hijinks, that's going to be an absolute blast. So that's a lot of fun to come hopefully for WrestleZone in the future. And then we've got Chaos, and then there'll be Summerhill, and there might be some shows in between. Who knows? I don't know. I just know I had a good time tonight. My voice is cracked. I am tired. I am going to go and get my pizza. And I am going to go and go pick up my son, and then go home, and hope he falls asleep in the car, and then for another 4 hours after that. I can only dream. I can only dream of that. So yeah, thank you to everyone that I said had the kind words for me. I'm rambling now, as I always do. Thank you for watching this really condensed version of the SWN podcast with a terrible montage of photos of just people entering the ring, maybe exiting. Who knows? I haven't went back and checked them. But yeah, I had a blast. And Callum as well. Callum and Rachel. Thanks for keeping company while I was waiting for the queue to begin and the show to start. I had a really great time. And I can't wait to bring back the podcast properly. It will happen this year. I just don't know when. I'm hoping October. That's what I'm aiming for. October, I'm going to have some Sharp Dojo series. I'm going to have some SWM podcast. Maybe one or two episodes. I don't think I can commit to one a week, but I'm going to do my absolute best to bring back the podcast as much as I can. Anyway, this has been an absolute delight, and I'm going to go get food now. So yeah, have a good one. Hope you enjoyed the show if you're at it. If you're listening to this and watching this and you still haven't been to a WrestleZone show or haven't been to an independent show in general, get a ticket, take the ride, and just go enjoy some fun wrestling. You can go check out SWN podcast, SWNScotland.com, that's the website. You can check out at Scott Resnett on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. You can find the podcast on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, just about everywhere. If you've got any queries at all, you're better to DM me on Twitter at Scott Resnett, or if you want to email me, scottresnett@gmail.com. If you go onto the website, there's links for our store as well if you want to get stickers and what have you. But no, have a good time, everyone. Who knows when the next podcast will be, but stay tuned.
Hello, I'm back in this studio. As you can see, it's still as badly lit as ever. So yeah, after all that adventure the last 30 minutes, if you've watched it, I thank you for watching all of that. And we did get a question into the mailbag, I suppose we'll call it that, before we wrap up and go on our way. So yeah, for the show itself, it was just so much fun. I haven't done a written review of it. I think Adam's pretty much summed up for me, and I'm sure by the time this comes out or by the time you listen to it, the K&K Wrestle Factory will do the exact same job. They'll be able to sum up just how much fun the show was. It was great fun. That I keep saying the word fun over and over again, but that's what it was. It's what wrestling really should be at times. Sometimes you can have these big emotive moments. Sometimes you can have these times where you're absolutely drained of any thought and just be absolutely mind blown. But really, the best thing about going to see wrestling is just having a lot. Just enjoy yourself, just having a good time. And that's exactly what WrestleZone and Inverurie did. It just, from top to bottom, every single match delivered a fun night. Whether it was intentional, whether it was Bruiser Brad or Rhys Dawkins, absolutely just decking themselves, missing the ring apron, whether it was them hitting the beams above them on the lower roof with the lower ring, which is a thing I'm not going to ever get used to seeing a lower set ring. It looked very weird, very out of place, but you make do with what space you've got, I suppose. But no, it was fantastic. All the matches just, it was so good. So the question we did get in, though, was from Ronan King, making another lyrical appearance on this podcast. He's just asked, how much of a disgrace is it that Ronan King didn't get an announcement post for Halloween Hijinks, but Grado did? I didn't even know you weren't on the poster. The poster didn't come out until after the show. It's an absolute disgrace. We need to know that Ronan King is at every event. That's the answer you're hoping for and looking for. I'm hoping to get to Halloween Hijinks to see you give Grado a piece of your mind, and that you're able to show why you should be on every single WrestleZone poster. But it was, that match itself was going to be incredible. I'm absolutely positive. Whether it's, I don't think it's going to be a technical classic, but it's going to be memorable. It's going to be moments that Ronan won't forget. I'm sure everyone in at WrestleZone in the audience won't forget either. I think that sums up the episode. So thank you very much for indulging me a little bit in Billy's Inverurie invasion, I think I've called the episode here. We'll be back soon with more interviews. I do have a list of people that either have contacted me that want to come on to the show, or I've contacted them to see if they're interested in being interviewed by myself for SWM podcast. So we do have people in place. I just need to find time and then make arrangements to actually get the episodes recorded and released. So I can't wait to tell you when I've got one ready to go, when a guest ready to interview, so you can get your questions in. But in the meantime, I'm going to go and try and get some more sleep as a new father. And in the meantime, you can also go to swnscotland.com and you can find out just everything about Scottish wrestling, about the companies we cover, about champions, results, shows. We've got some video content as well, and all that good stuff as well. So follow us on Twitter, @ScottResNet, and just have a good time. Have a good one. See ya.
DENNIS. The dentist system. That, my friends, is the key.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Oh, yeah.